YouTube, how are you? Welcome to hashtag Religion Week. I told you we're gonna try to have a lot of fun on here, lighten up the load. But in my last video, I asked you guys a question. First of all, welcome to Tower Talk. It's where we talk it up to Yahweh. You can have your tea with no shade, okay? And nothing but good news of the kingdom of God and the covenant of Yahweh. And us as the children of Israel, and how we've been Religion Week, and it's okay to repent and start learning our culture again. You see, when you stand with Yahweh, shade can't touch you. But when you stand with other gods, you're at risk of being scorched. Nonetheless, Yahweh is faithful and just. Let me make sure I get this right. To cleanse us of all unrighteousness and to forgive us of all our sins. I said it backwards in the last video, but we're human. We get to make mistakes. Hi, I'm Drew L. Murray. How are you? Basically, this video right here is just to really let you know how I've been living for the last... Well, I just turned 50 in October, so about back in 2014... I had a revelation that some things in the Bible wasn't adding up right. Could never line up with the Word of God like I'm supposed to. But, you know, I went to who am I in the Bible as a black person, and here we are today. Basically, I am a black woman, as you can see. I've been called African, never Hebrew, although there's a Hebrew book in the Bible talking to some Hebrews that were the children of Israel. I study from a Greek book, which is not the Word of God, but it's the inspired Word of God put together by Greek and Roman men, European scholars, who had the Bible plenty of years, since at least 1600 when they tried, you know, to get it from King James or whatever. That's another teaching. But what I'm trying to say is, I'm reading from and studying my culture and my spirituality from the traditions of Greek people. And then I speak English, like the European queen. Go figure, right? Have you been Religion Winked as well? Hashtag Religion Winked, okay? Have you been Religion Winked? I have too, and I'm here sitting on this channel saying, look, I've been through some things because I couldn't line up with the Word of God as in Christianity would want you to. And about 3 years ago, God started saying, well, maybe this is why, Drew. It's okay to look at something differently, you know. So, again, I'm a black woman, African, Hebrew, Jew, studying my spirituality and my covenant and my relationship with God through a Greek book. And I speak an English tongue, not even like the queen. Mine is the watered-down peasant kind of English. So, with that being said, hi, I'm Drew L. Murray, all screwed up in the head, spiritually and religiously like you are. But it's okay. We can break down each section of it, line by line, precept by precept, word by word, revelation and wisdom from Yahweh himself. And we can get through this, because I thought I was going to be done with religion after I found out some of the truths about Christianity. But, no, it just makes me press further toward Yahweh and the covenant. And you will too, because when Christ says his burden is light, his yoke is light, and his burden is easy, the commandments and laws and statutes, it really is easy. Religion and tradition, and of course being black people, Hebrew people, following the Roman Greek cultures and traditions through Christianity, makes life hard, right? Wouldn't you agree? So we'll get into a lot of this. I just wanted to let you know, hey, it's okay to be a little screwed up, because I'm a black woman, African, Hebrew, Israelite, Jew, children of Israel, studying from a Greek Bible, Greek words, every dictionary I look up, every word is Greek. But then I have an English tongue. So there's something wrong there, right? It's a major cover-up and conspiracy. And I hope you would agree in Psalms 83 that you can find this craftiness and cunningness that was that raised his head up against God and his people. So if you're wondering why life does not line up with the word of God like you really want it to, I know it does for some people, but for other people it just simply don't. And it's because some of those people may be Greek and Roman following Christianity, which comes from the Roman Empire and the Greek Empire. Other of us are Hebrew from Israel, from Jerusalem, from that tribe of the 12, the 10 they say is still lost and missing, that the Romans ran out of their inhabitant in 70 AD. We're some of those people who really believe that we have to get back to Yahweh and his covenant. So with that being said, I'm Drew, D-R-U-L Murray. And I am just as confused as you is, but thanks be to God and his word, because, let's see, what can I give you? What can I give you? He says, beloved, I wish above all things you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. And this is one of the ways my soul is prospering, being able to share with you my testimony about who I am and how Christianity have got me through for the most part. Like I said, I believed in white Jesus and Christianity up until about 3 years ago. I still believe in Christ, which Christians derive from that word, but it was never meant for people to have the stigma or the label of Christians on them. And it was never meant for the religion of Christianity, which is actually Christ, anti, however you want to look at that word. It's saying Christ Dianti in the Greek or the Roman or whatever, Latin. But in the Hebrew, you wouldn't find that word, because that word Christianity does not exist. So, how you... There's so much truth and not truth, fiction and non-fiction. You just have to purpose in your heart what's real to you, your culture, your people, your way of life. And for some of us, we found that there's a lot of false doctrine in Christianity that has the church rampant like it is, following the pagan ways of other gods such as Jesus and Zeus. If you look up the names, you would understand the word Jesus originate from the Greek, but the word Yeshua is what the word Jesus is a rendition of. It's right there in the world's Bible, which is called Webster's Dictionary. They did a great job, hashtag religion winking us, hashtag religion winking. They did a great job with hashtag religion wink to confuse the masses, to cover up a lot of their sins. But they want to put the sin on you and cause you to run around here and focus on probably things that don't really matter to God. What matters to God is you stop eating their pork. What matters to God is you just go back to the Ten Commandments and the two Jesus gave you. Start there. You know, there's a lot of commandments and ordinances and statutes. Start with the small things and work your way back into the greater things with God. Because we've been led astray, following other gods. And I have I'm going to do another video on some of the abominations that we were taught as Christians, some of the other gods we follow as Christians. So with that being said, God bless you. Thank you. I appreciate you all. There's nothing perfect about me, but I do have a willing heart to 2 Timothy 2:15, rightly study to show myself approved unto Yahweh, a workman needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, so that we all can be set free, so that we all can be on one accord, so that we all can be of one mind, so that we all can be of one mission and one journey, and that is to build temples within people, which is the kingdom of God. We've been taught to follow and preach the gospel of Christ, but again, there's one greater than Christ, and I will say it's Yahweh. He looked to the left and the right, and he saw none but himself. Yahweh is I am that I am. We are all an extension of the great I am that I am, even Yeshua, even Christ. So we can kind of get to Christ to get us back to Yahweh. That's the covenant. All right? I'm in covenant with Yahweh. I just wanted you to know that, like, you can trust me. Talk to me. Like, share, subscribe. Do what you have to do. Because we've all been in the same, probably, shoes, boat, belly of the whale, prison like Paul. We've been there. You can see yourself in the Bible. And when I begin to see myself in the Bible lining up with the persecution, with the oppression, with the slavery, with the words and the choices God gave some people, and also the blessing is there, and there's the curse. You see yourself lining up like, wait a minute. This adds up. This isn't adding up. Why is it working for some people and not for me and for everybody else? And then it's working for me, but not everybody in my family. And what is going on? Doubt and unbelief. So, with that being said, exhort, encourage, and comfort one another out of their doubt and unbelief. That's what this channel is here to do for us all. It's about doubt and unbelief. People still doubt. I got some, again, Drew, D-R-U-L, Murray. Go check out Facebook. Request my friendship. Go over there. Look at some of the early on videos. I started labeling some Tower Talk, but prior to that, a lot of the live stream, if it's a video, wasn't titled, because I don't believe in titling everything. But when you want people to go right to a certain video, or when you want somebody to hear a certain message and click on your video because they want to see what's there. So, you know, boom, you want to know what the video is about. So I started labeling things and titles. I hope these titles are great for you. I hope they draw your attention in. We gonna get into a lot of things, but one of the things I know is when God sends people your way, it's how they look, it's how they sound, it's how everything about them is not appealing to you, like it was the children of Israel, and they would never listen to the prophets and the men and women God sent before them at that point in time. And it's like that today. We look at how people sound, how they look, what their background is, and we get caught up in that. We get unfocused. We lose our train of thought. And then we're so far from the mission or the purpose or the calling that's really on our lives. So I don't get caught up in the vain things of life. What I do get caught up is in the Word of God and His plan for His people, and to see His people prosper, to see His people not to be oppressed, because this was never our life. This was never your life. Okay, this is never for us. So, anyhow, how you living? We gonna be living just fine. We are living just fine. We are doing just fine. Why? Because Yahweh says He teaches us to profit. How? He gives us power to get wealth. How do we get wealthy? You study, you educate, you learn. Whatever it is you want to get wealthy in, you have to educate yourself in that. I would love to get wealthy in the Word of God so that I can speak to some of these things and call things that be not as though they were, move mountains, increase my faith, you know, just see my world manifest because of the words I'm choosing to speak. That's what Jesus did. Christ. Well, Jesus, again, is an origin name from the Greek. It's a rendition of Yeshua. So with that being said, even as Christ came fulfilling His calling as being a representative, an ambassador from God, as we're ambassadors, and He came He came witnessing as we're to witness. He came performing miracles and doing things as we're to do them, greater than He. So I know we can break through and overcome and allow our Yahweh and covenant with Yahweh be greater than what it really looks like. And what that really looks like for me is I'm a black woman learning a whole bunch of Greek words in this same Bible that's supposed to be spiritually connecting me with a covenant with Yahweh that's from a Hebrew standpoint, maybe from a Jewish perspective, but yet here I am speaking a Queen's language and it has nothing to do with Hebrew. Exactly. So you can see, right? You can see. I never been to Bible school, seminary. I feel some people that go to school come out just as dull as they go in, spiritually. They have no power in the Word of God. They have no revelation. You can go learn all this stuff, but if it's not a direct spiritual, spirit-to-spirit conversation with God, again, the studying, the preparing, yes, they got to sit down 2-3 weeks before to get you the sermon on Sunday. But honey, let me tell you something. If the anointing of God rests upon you, you can wake up out to sleep Sunday morning and preach the church down. That's just how it go. But that's where we grieve the spirit and things like that as well. There's a lot of things we do. And we're going to get into a lot of that the Bible says we shouldn't be doing. So, with that being said, guys, I really appreciate you. I love you all so much. I'm looking forward to networking, communicating, talking it up to Yahweh, exhorting, encouraging, and comforting one another on this channel. Because that's what it's about nowadays. If you're not for Yahweh, you're for the ruler of this world. And that's just the bottom line. And what we have to be mindful of is, what are you leaving? I know some of you like to say legacy. I've been trained to say an inheritance to my children's children. But what are we leaving them? What are we leaving them? Okay? And that's the thing here. So I'm Drew, D-R-U. L is my middle initial. Murray, M-U-R-R-A-Y is my last name. Forgive the nerves. I'm going to, like I said, lighten up. You'll see for yourself. You don't have to say what kind of person you are or who you are. You don't need a witness because there's a witness in heaven that bears witness to all things. So, you know, I trust you. You trust me. I don't disrespect you. You don't disrespect me. I don't, you know, drag you through the mud. You don't, you can do. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And the same thing with you. Again, it's doubt and unbelief. For a long time, I doubted myself as a Christian, as a person who followed Christianity, because I could never quite line up with the Word of God. But I've been so much freer now. I'm lining up. We're lining up together. Yahweh is lining up with us because we line up with one another. And it's going to be an awesome journey. You're an ambassador of Christ. You're a soldier for Christ. You must contend the faith. There's a lot of things we have to go along in this life and do. But it's not grievous. It's something you would do for your regular family. It's something you would do for somebody you love. You go out your way. You make a lot of sacrifices. All God is saying is just be obedient to me. And it's less stressful than you out there making your sacrifices trying to please mankind. I had to learn. I was that kind of Christian. I was that kind of believer. I still believe in God. His name is Yahweh. Christ, his name is Yeshua. The gospel of Christ is preaching and teaching Christ's ways. And the church doesn't even do that nowadays. So, I'm just that voice. John 12:30 says, this voice is not for my sake, it's for your sake. But that was Jesus saying it to us. So, and he says, if you be in him and he be in you, then we all in the Father. Amen? Or we can say, so be it, okay? Because I say, amen sounds like omen, and we just got to get away from sound. We got to get back to who we really are. And our culture is pretty cool. That's why Winston Churchill said, paraphrasing, we are the most formidable and remarkable race that ever appeared into the into the world. check it out. Just Google Winston Churchill's quotes. But I have it written in the book. It's going up on Amazon.com. You can find 12 other books there, from babies to Black Lives Matter to my white Christian faith to then my black children of Hebrew experiences. And the last book that I have going out, which I'm trying to find my CreateSpace email account password, is The Covenant, My Truth, and Me. So, it's the same for you. If we started our journey the same, remember you had that black Moses, let my people go. I know my mom had one in her house. We grew up with that fist. Let my people go. So anyway, God is saying the same thing. Let my people go, okay? And we're going to be let go. They're going to let us go. We're going to be free. And how? In this truth. The next video I would love to do and share with you is just to show you in the King James Version how the word Yahweh, Yeshua, is in the Bible, but yet they went through the whole entire Bible and put God and Jehovah and Jesus and Christ in there. So, again, I know Jesus is like, they done gave me so many names. I'm like, they done gave me black, they done gave me Greek, they done gave me English, European English, you know, just like the Haitians. They got Greek, French controlling them. You know, it's like, people have people still controlling them and enslaving them with language, with culture, with traditions. And we have to break that. So my name is Drew L. Murray. We're going to do our best to do that on this channel. We're going to exhort, encourage, and lift one another up with comfort. Edify one another. Show how we can and cannot, receive this word. Get rid of the doubt and unbelief and believe that you are who God said you are. You can do what God says you can do, and you can be who God calls you to be. That's my hope and prayer for you. I keep it short because Jesus says, don't be like those in the marketplace that stand on the corner and make their alms and prayers and long gowns and all this other stuff. He says, you want your righteousness to exceed to be great? Let it exceed those of the Pharisees and the scribes. Learn what the Pharisees and the scribes do in the book of Matthew, and you'll do much better than them. And we have been doing much better than them. And we can do much better than them. So, I think this is going to be a great time that we share with one another. Eventually, I'm going to be able to set things up where we go live and have that conversation. Like, share, subscribe. Leave your comments below. Like I said, I'll never get on your page or channel and disrespect you. So, please, be respectful of people. That's the start of just seeing a change in this world. It's just being respectful of people. Everybody has an opportunity to speak what they've been given to speak, thus saith the Lord. And we don't have to judge any of that, because the Bible, same said so, Bible says prophets will judge is subject to the prophet. Read the book. It says prophets is subject to another prophet with no another prophet. And like I said, I believe God only dealt with judges, kings, high priests, and prophets. And you know, the Bible says desire the prophecy. Not everybody walks in the office of a prophet, but we all hear from God. We all have a personal relationship with God. We all may be hearing something different, but it's how you present it to the people if it's going to be received or not. So with that being said, God bless you. Thank you again. Now let me say this right, because I left out graces in the last video. May Yahweh bless you and keep you, make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you, let his conscience rest upon you, and his shalom, that is peace, be in you. God bless you. Enjoy until the next video. Exhort, comfort, encourage one another. Because everybody's so busy tearing it down out there. What is we teaching the young ones behind us? If our generation is doing this to one another, what are we doing to the children? And like I said, if you have other nations causing you to be a black person studying from a Greek Bible, speaking the English language, go figure, honey. Let's address that right there. Let's just deal with that. Sort that out. People will stop being confused like I was. And like so many of you are not now that you understand that it just doesn't fit in your culture. It's just not part of your DNA. It's just not something maybe we shouldn't be doing, but maybe doing differently. So I'm Drew, D-R-U-L, Murray, M-U-R-R-A-Y. Thank you very much. God bless you and enjoy the rest of your day.